Dear students, good afternoon all. Today we will study about what? Electricity. Okay. The chapter class 10 what? Electric what? City. Okay. CIT. Electricity of class what? 10. Now, electricity in our day-to-day life, you can see it plays a major role in our day-to-day life. It is used in what? Any types of appliances, electrical appliances, as well as electrical what? Gadgets. Okay. Now, in these chapters, we shall discuss about what? Electric what? Current. Electric what? Current. Electric current and then what? Electric what? Circuit. Now, let us consider, we know metals, metals are good conductor of what? Heat and electricity. Okay. Let us consider a copper wire. Okay. Copper wire. There are large number of free electrons on it. When it is connected, let us consider, when it is connected to a cell, as a result, what happens? The electrons here moves in a what? In a particular direction. It is positive at this point, here it will what? Positive. The negative charge always acts as the what? Positive charge. So it moves in the direction from what? Electrons moves from what? Negative towards the what? Positive. Electron moves from what? Negative towards the positive. When this charge moves in a certain time, then what you can say? What? Current. This is nothing but what? Current. What do you mean by current? Current is nothing but what? Is equal to what? Rate of flow of what? Of charge. Rate of flow of charge is called what? Current. That is I. It implies what you can add I denotes what? Current. Current equal to charge divided by what? Time. Charge divided by what? Time. Okay. Now, charge divided by what? Time. Now, if I consider when the current moves in direction, flow of what? Current. When current moves in this particular direction, okay, that the negative charge, there are two types of charge, that is positively charged and the what? Negative charge. When the flow of charge is in this direction, then the flow of negative charge flows in this what? Opposite direction of the flow of what? Current. Okay, the flow of what? Flow of negative what? Charge. Current moves in this direction, the flow of negative charge will be in this direction. Means electron moves in the what? Here E minus, electron is denoted by E minus. The electron moves in the what? Opposite what? Direction of the flow of current. This is the nothing but conventional flow. This is called what? Conventional flow of what? Current. When the flow of charge of current, flow of current is in this direction, and then what you can say, the flow of positive charge will be along the what? Same what? Direction. The flow of what? Positive charge will be in the same direction. Okay. Now, what we consider, when the current moves, when the negative charge moves in this direction, then current moves in the opposite direction. When what is considered the direction in which the opposite positive charge flows at same in the same direction, the flow of current occurs. Okay. Now, this is about what? Current. Now, current is nothing but what? The rate of flow of charge, that is I equal to charge by what? Time. Now, what is the unit of charge? what? Charge. Now, unit of charge. Unit of charge is what? Coulomb. 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 Denoted by what? C. Now, unit of current. Unit of current is ampere. AMPERD. Ampere. It is denoted by what? Capital what? A. Okay. It is denoted by what? Capital what? A. Now, let us consider this. Now, let us consider this is a bulb. Okay. This is a what? A battery. This is positive terminal. This is negative terminal. When one cell is there, then it is called cell. When one or more cell, this is called what? A battery. Here, let us consider we apply what? A key. Okay. Now, this is what? We are getting what? Bulb. Here, the current will flow. The current flows in this direction. Okay. When it is what? This is what condition? Switch. The switch is what? Switch on. Then it becomes a what? Here the current moves from here and then it moves to this bulb and it comes back. As a result, this is nothing but we say what? This is nothing but what? These are nothing but the connecting what? Wires. Okay. This is what? Electric bulb. When current passes through it, as a result, this light what? Blows. This we are getting what? Light here. Okay. Now, when it is, this is a what? Closed circuit. The this is called electric what? Circuit. Okay. Now, if the circuit is what? Off, then what will happen? When the circuit is off, then what? It does not form a closed loop. As a result, the light will not what? Blow. The light, this light will not emit what? An energy. That is what? Light energy. Okay. This light will not emit any energy. Okay, light energy. Okay. Now, what we have studied till now, that I equal to what? Q by what? T. Now, when Q equal to I equal to Q by what? T. When Q equal to 1 coulomb and T equal to what? 1 second. Then I equal to what we are getting? 1 by 1 is equal to 1 coulomb by 1 second. That is 1 coulomb by 1 second. 1 second equal to 1 coulomb what? Per second. Is nothing but equal to what? We are getting what? 1 ampere. So what is? When 1 coulomb of charge, when 1 coulomb of charge flows through a conducting wire for 1 second, then how much ampere of current is produced? 1 ampere of current is what? Produced. Okay. Now, what are the other units we can apply for? We can, if the current is small, then we apply 1 milliampere. Milli means 10 to the power minus 3 ampere. Okay. And 1 microampere equal to how much? 10 to the power minus 6 ampere. Okay. Now, in a circuit, to measure what current, we use an instrument, we use an appliance that is known as ammeter. Ammeter means what? See here, this is a circuit, this is a cell, positive terminal, negative what? Negative. Okay. Negative. A bulb is connected here. Then we are getting, this is an ammeter. Here positive, see here, positive, it becomes positive. If I consider a switch, this is a switch, which is what? That is what? Key. That is in on condition. This is battery. Okay. This is bulb. Now, this is positive, this is what? Negative. The current flows from here. This is the direction of the flow of current. Now, this is nothing but an emitter. This is what? Emitter. What is the function of an emitter? The function of an emitter is to measure what? Current in an what? Electrical what? Circuit.
it is connected in what type of connection? The same amount of current, the if I consider I is the same amount of current passing, so in this what connecting wires, then same amount of current will pass to this what emitter. Same amount of current passes to this what emitter also. Okay. Now this is in what connection? The emitter is connected in the emitter. It is what connected in what? It is connected in what series? What type of connection it is? We are applying. It is connected in what connection? Series connection. Okay. Later we will discuss what is series, what is parallel connection. Okay. Now, we will discuss about what electric what potential. Electric what potential? Electric potential what difference? Okay, electric potential what difference and as well as what potential what difference? Okay, now let us consider a pipe. Okay, it consists of water. Now see the water. The water here, the water will not flow because they are of the what same level. Now if that there is difference in the level, let us consider the water in this. Here it consists of water. Now if I consider, so there is difference, here it is at higher potential, here it is at not lower potential. So water automatically flows in what? From higher potential towards the what? Lower what potential. So in case of, why does a charge flow? Charge flows as here, if you see the water water flows from the higher to what lower, this is that what, this is a difference in the what level. Similarly, difference in the level, or we can say difference in the what potential what energy. It is at higher, it is at what lower potential. Here in this case, these two are in what, they are in the what same level. So water does not what flow in this level, the water will not flow. But in case of a conductor. Okay, in a conductor, if I see, let us consider a conductor. Okay, in a conductor, the electrons are in what random motion. The electrons will be are in a random motion. Okay, free electrons are in what random motion? They are in random motion. Okay, one moves in this direction, another move in this direction. Okay, we are not getting a particular what direction. Okay, electrons are in what random motion. But when a potential difference is created by a cell, okay, when this is the what, this is a conductor, let us consider, and this is a cell, this is positive terminal and this one is negative terminal. When or cell or a battery is connected, okay, as a result, the negatively charged, the electrons that is negative, moves in what? A particular direction with a velocity known as what? Drift velocity. Whatever velocity? Drift velocity. Here it is positive, so it becomes positive, it becomes what? Negative. Means there will be a potential what? Difference. It will be at higher potential and it will be at lower potential. So electron, this is electron, the electron moves towards the what? Towards the what? Positive terminal. And the electron moves what? The electron moves in this direction. The electrons are moving in this what particular what direction. Okay, when the electrons are moving in a particular direction, then the current will flow in which direction? In the what? Opposite direction to the flow of what current. Now this flow is being created by whom? By this what? Cell. By this cell or what? Battery. Okay, this is created by cell or what? Battery. Okay, now in order to move, let us consider this point is what, in order to move a charge, in order to move a charge. Now that negative charge particle moves from what? From here to here, and the positive charge particle moves from what? From positive terminal towards the what? Negative terminal. Now if a charge Q, let us consider this is a point, any point, okay. If you consider A, then this is the point what? B. Okay. Now when this charge, a small charge Q, is moved from one position to another position, we have to do a certain amount of work. Work is done to move a charge from one point to what? A positive charge to move from one point to what? Another point. Okay. Now Now this is at higher potential, this is at what? Lower potential. Okay. Now potential, so work done is nothing but equal to potential into what we are getting? Work done is nothing but potential into what? Potential into what? Charge. That is, potential is equal to work done by what? Charge. Potential is nothing but work done by what? What? Work done by what? Charge. To move this charge from one point to another point, a work has to be done. This work done per unit charge is known as what? What? Electric what? Potential. That is electric potential what? Difference. Then what do you say about electric potential difference? Electric potential difference is the amount of work done to move a charge from one point to another point. Now what is the unit of this potential? Potential what difference? The unit of potential difference, potential difference is what? Volt, V-O-L-T, volt means what? V is what? V. Okay. The unit of potential difference is what? Volt. Okay. Now this is a battery, this is a bulb. Now this is one battery is connected, positive, negative. This is a emitter, let us consider positive, negative. This is a what? This is switch on, the plug is what? On. Now so this is a voltmeter, positive, negative. It will be a voltmeter which measures the what? Potential what? Difference, which is connected in what? A voltmeter is used to measure the potential what? Difference, which is used in what type of connection? In what? Parallel connection. It is used in what? What connection? Parallel connection. Okay. And yeah, oh, and we always know that an emitter is connected in what type of connection? It is connected in what? Series what? Connection. Okay. Emitter, voltmeter in what? Parallel, in parallel connection. Emitter is in what? Series what? Connection. Okay. Now about what? Electric circuit. In the electric circuit, what are the things we are using? Electric what? Circuit. Okay. Electric circuit diagram. What are the things we are using? Okay. Now this is a bulb. This is what is a bulb? This is called what? This is called what? Resistance. Here this is a what? What resistance? We are using what? Fixed resistance. If I take this one or this diagram, this is called what? Rheostat. Means what? Means variable resistance. What resistance? Variable what? Resistance. Now this is bulb, this is what we say positive negative, this is called what? Cell. Okay, now when two or more cells are connected, then it is positive negative, positive negative, positive negative, then this is called what? Battery. This is called what? Battery. Okay, now this is cells and as well as what? Battery. Now see, this is a what? Joint. Joint means this wire is connected, this is a line, this is a what? Wire, and another wire is connected to it. This is a what? Joint. J-O-I-N-T. Joint. And now see, if this is a wire and this wire is not connected, simple jump means what it indicates, this wire is not connected with this wire. For that reason we use this one. Okay, means one wire, the if I consider this is length, this is a wire L1 and this is the what? L2. This wire is not connected with the wire L1. Okay. Now if I write this one, okay, this is what, or in the higher classes you will get this one, means what? It means the switch is what? The switch is on. Now if I put this one or this one, the switch is what? The switch is what? Off. This one is what? When dot is given, you indicate when this one is connected, this is what? Switch on. And when this one, when dot is not given, this one is what? Switch what? Off. Okay. Then this is what? Emitter. 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 Emitter means which measures what? Current. It is connected in what connection? Series connection. And this is what? A voltmeter. This is positive, this is negative. This is a what? Volt what? Meter. Okay. This is what? What? Voltmeter. Okay. Now we will study about what? Ohm's law. Ohm's law. Okay. Ohm's law. Let us form a circuit. Okay. Here a bulb is connected and here there is a what? Positive. This one is negative. Okay. This is a emitter what? Reading. Okay. Now if I connect a voltmeter across it, positive, this one is negative, voltmeter. Okay. Now here at first one cell is connected. Okay. Now if I take V, okay. Now voltage V1, let us consider V1, then what? V. Each cell has a potential of what? V. Okay. Now if when this one is connected with first with connected with what? If I take the reading of V and what? I. Here the reading of voltage will be given. Here the voltage reading of what? Current is what? Given. Taken. Okay. Now when one cell is connected, then what? When the one cell is connected, then the reading is get, the, we are getting the what? Voltage reading. we are getting the potential reading, here we will getting the what current reading.
When two cells are connected, we are getting what voltage reading, here we are getting the current reading. When three cells are connected, okay, we are getting the voltage reading as well as the what current reading. Let us consider, when 2 volt is applied, let us consider we are getting current 2. When 4 volt, when 2 is applied, if I consider 2 volt is applied, we are getting 4, here also what 4. If I, when it is applying 6, we are, let us consider the current, we are getting what 6. Means what, when this value increases, then this value also what goes on what increasing, okay. The value, when the voltage increases, then current also what increases. The according to Ohm's law, what Ohm's law states that at constant what temperature, at constant what temperature, what at constant temperature, potential is directly proportional to what, potential is directly proportional to what current. When voltage increases, when potential increases, then what current also what increases. Now, in order to remove this proportionality symbol, we put a constant of proportionality R. No, the constant of proportionality. This constant of proportionality is known as what? Resistance. This is called what? Resistance of the what? Cell. Resistance. Sorry, resistance. This is called what? Resistance. Resistance of the cell, not. This is the what? Simple, we say what? Resistance only. Okay. Now, now what we have? Now, at constant what temperature, voltage is directly proportional to current, and voltage equal to current into what? R. R into I means voltage equal to resistance into what current I. Okay. Now, unit of resistance. The unit of resistance is what? Ohm. The unit of resistance is what? Ohm. Okay. The unit of resistance is what? Ohm. This is a Greek what symbol? Okay. This is a what symbol? Greek symbol. Okay. Now we will study about next thing. What are the factors on which resistance of a wire, what are the factors on which the resistance depends? Okay. Now, let us consider, this is a wire, okay, of length L, and this area is cross sectional area is what? A. Okay. The area of cross section is what? A. Now, resistance of a wire, this wire is of length, L is the length of the wire, this is the area of what? Cross section. Area of cross section means the cross sectional area, this one. Okay. If I consider this a wire, this is of length L, and this is the area of what? Cross section. Okay. Now, what are the factors on which the resistance of the wire depend? Factors. Now, resistance is directly proportional to what? Length. One means resistance, resistance is directly proportional to what? Length. Resistance is directly proportional to length, and resistance is inversely proportional to what? Area of what? Cross section. A is nothing but what? What? This is what? Area of what? Cross section. Area of what? Cross section. Okay. And this is the what? Length. It depends on the nature of the what? It depends on the what? Material also. Okay. Now, this is equation 1, this one is equation what taken as what? 2. Okay. Now, combining combining 1 and 2, what we are getting? So, R is directly proportional to L by A,
Now this is a proportionality symbol. If I want to remove this proportionality symbol, we have to put a what? Constant. This is called rho. Rho. This is called constant of proportionality, known as what? Resistivity. Resistivity. Okay, this is known as what? Resistivity. Okay, rho is a constant. R equal to, we put a symbol rho in into what? L by A. Rho is called what? Resistivity of the material. Okay, now see, as it depends upon what? Temperature. So we can also say the resistivity also depends upon the what? Temperature. Okay, resistivity also depends upon the what? Temperature. So R equal to rho into L by what? A. Okay. Now now see, if I consider conductor and insulators, okay. Now in case of what? Conductor. In case of conductor, what will get? In case of conductor, the resistance will be the resistivity will be what? Low. And the conductivity is what? High. In case of insulators, what will get? In case of insulator, the conductivity will be low and the resistivity would be what? High. Okay. Now 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 next topic, that is resistances in what? Series. Okay, resistance in what? Series. Another topic that we will discuss is resistance in what? Parallel. Now let us take, this is the symbol of resistance. Let us take this resistance R1, this one is another resistance R2, and this one is another resistance what? R3. Okay, now they are connected with a connecting wires. They are connected with a what? Cell or a battery. Okay. This is positive, this one is what? Negative. Okay. Now this voltage is V. Now as a result, here what will flow? The current flows to the resistance R1, R2 and what? R3. R1, R2 and R3. Now same amount of current will pass. This I amount of current will pass through R1 as well as R2 as well as what? R what? 3. Same amount of current passes through R1, R2 and what? R3. So in case of this, as a result, if I put here a potential, here I into R1, there will be a potential drop. Let us consider this is V1. Here there will be another potential drop. Let us consider this is V2. And this one here, the potential drop what? V3. Now what is the total potential supplied? The V will be equal to the summation of V1 plus V2 plus what? V3. V1 plus V2 plus what? V3. So what you can say, in a series connection, the currents remains what? The current remain what? Same. It the same amount of current passes through the what? All the what? Resistance. Now we know according to Ohm's law, voltage equal to current into what? Current into what? Resistance. I into R1 plus I into what? R2 plus I into what? R3. So equal to I into R1 plus R2 plus what? R3. Okay. Now if I consider the same cell has been applied here, having the same where the potential is V, and we have removed the what? The three resistance, and we have taken what? One resistance. That is what we say what? The value of this one is R equivalent. Okay. Now it draws same amount of what? Current. Then what will be the value? Voltage equal to current into what? Into what? Resistance. Okay. Now here V equal to how much? I into what? R1 plus R2 plus R3. This is equation 1. एंड दिस इज व्हाट इक्वेशन व्हाट टू. तो फ्रॉम वन एंड टू वी गेट सी फ्रॉम वन एंड टू वी गेट आई इंटू आर इक्विवेलेंट इक्वल टू व्हाट आई इंटू व्हाट आर वन प्लस आर टू प्लस आर थ्री. देन व्हाट वी आर गेटिंग एट आर इक्विवेलेंट इक्वल टू आई आई गेट कैंसल आर वन प्लस आर टू प्लस आर थ्री. इन केस ऑफ सीरीज कनेक्शन व्हाट विल डू विल ऐड द रेजिस्टेंस विल ऐड द वैल्यूज ऑफ द व्हाट रेजिस्टेंस सिंपली सिंपल व्हाट एडिशन. ओके तो व्हाट यू कैन से अबाउट रेजिस्टेंस इन ए सर्किट रेजिस्टेंस इन व्हाट सीरीज इन व्हेन द रेजिस्टेंस आर कनेक्टेड इन सीरीज करेंट रिमेन्स व्हाट सेम एंड द इक्विवेलेंट रेजिस्टेंस विल बी इक्वल टू द सम ऑफ ऑल द रेजिस्टेंस सम ऑफ ऑल द वैल्यू ऑफ ऑल द थ्री व्हाट रेजिस्टेंस. ओके नाउ वी विल स्टडी अबाउट about resistance in what connection parallel what connection. Now parallel connection in what is parallel connection the current will be what divided. Okay the current guess what divided the one resistance this is the another resistance this is the another one resistance. Okay let us name this resistance as R1 this resistance as R2 this one as R3. Okay now what you have to supply current from whom with the help of SL this is positive this is negative this is okay. Now as a result from here the current flows see here when the current flows here the I amount of current flows now here at this junction what you are getting here the this let us consider this current get divided into three part I1 another part is I2 another part is what I3. Now this amount of current is I1 is the current passing through the resistance R1 I2 is the current passing through what R2 and I3 is the current passing through the what R3. See this connection is known as what connection parallel connection. Okay here current gets what divided. Now see here I1 current would come out here in this. Okay then what same amount of current will flow. Okay then same amount of current what flows. Okay now what get divided here the current gets divided. So what you can write I this I current is nothing but equal to I is nothing but I1 plus I2 plus I equal to I1 plus I2 plus what I3. Okay now here it is positive so here there is no resistance so here it will become also positive here it will also become positive here is also positive. Now see negative terminal negative this one is also negative this one also negative the potential across the each resistor remains what same the potential remains what same across the each what resistor in a what parallel circuit. So what you can write now we know current equal to from Ohm's law what we know V is equal to I into R. So what you can I equal to what you can write V by R. Then what is the voltage here voltage V and current is what resistance is R V by R1 plus V by what R2 plus V by what R3. Okay what I take common V common तो 1 by R1 plus 1 by what R2 plus 1 by what R3. Okay now from the if I remove if same cell is connected here okay same amount of current and removing the three resistance we put one resistance only. Okay this is known as R equivalent then current what is what is the current I equal to voltage by R equivalent. If I consider this equation as 1, this equation as what? 2. Then what? From 1 and 2 we get what? V by R equivalent equal to 1. What we are getting? V into 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. Okay. Now V, V get cancelled. What we are getting? 1 by R equivalent equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. So what is the equivalent resistance? Is nothing but 1 by R equivalent equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 1 by what? R3. Okay. This is about what? Series connection. Now if I say what, this is resistance 2 ohm and this one is what? 3 ohm. Okay. Now here the current gets divided into two parts, in this direction, in this direction. Here the resistance is 2 ohm, here it is what? 3 ohm. What is the equivalent resistance? Then for this circuit, 1 by R equivalent equal to 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3, that is 6, 3 plus 2, that is equal to, what is R equivalent will be equal to 6 by 5 watt ohm. Okay. Clear? This is about what? Parallel connection. So what we have learned still now? In this resistance, in series connection resistance are what? In series, so R equivalent equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3 we are getting, and in what? Parallel connection. In parallel connection, 1 by R equivalent equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by what? R3. Okay. Now, in the question, graph of Ohm's law. Graph of voltage versus what? Current. Now according to Ohm's law, if I increase, this is the voltage and this is the amount of what? This is the what? Current. If I take, then this will be a straight line which will passes to the what? What? This is a straight line which will passes to the what? Which will pass to the what? Origin. This is the what? Graph of what? Voltage versus what? What? Voltage versus what? Current. Okay. Now, in the exam, they ask the question, what is the unit of resistivity? Okay. What is the unit of what? Resistivity. Okay. Now R equal to rho into L by what? A, we know that take rho equal to R into A divided by what? L. Now what is the unit of resistance? That is what? Unit of resistance will be what? Ohm. And the unit of area is what? Meter square. Unit of length is what? Meter. Meter get cancelled. Then the unit of what? Resistivity is what? Vt will be what? Is ohm what? If I write ohm what? Meter. Unit of resistivity is what? Ohm what? Meter. Okay. Now we will study about what heating effects of what current. What effect? Heating effects of what current.
Okay. Now let us consider a circuit. Okay. Let us consider circuit. Let us. This is the current that flows.
Okay.
Now. 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 Heating effect of what current? This is a voltage that been applied. Now, when current passes through it, as a result, what we are getting? The light what blows. When the light blows, okay, it gives us the light energy, and we are getting also certain amount of what heat also. The, it becomes warm. If we touch this bulb, it becomes warm also. Now let us consider this fan. Okay, now when the fan rotates, okay, now it, the gadget also becomes what hot also. The when the gadget becomes hot, means certain heat is what radiated. Now in this what bulb also there is a resistance. As a result, what certain amount of heat get what dissipated. Okay, now what is the amount of heat dissipated? Now if in this circuit for T time, if the amount of heat produced is H equal to what I square R into what T. Okay, heat is directly proportional. Heat is the amount of heat produced in time t in the resistance. Then heat is equal to I square what R into what t, where I is nothing but your what current, current in the circuit. The R is the resistance and t is the what time what taken. Okay. Now this is this root. This is also known as Joule's law. Joule's law of what heating. Joule's law of what heating. So what is Joule's law of heating? Joule's law of heating states that the amount of heat, the heat is directly proportional to the square of the current. The heat is directly proportional to the what? Directly proportional to what? Resistance. And heat is directly proportional to the what? Time taken. So what? H is directly proportional to I square RT. Then what it becomes? H equal to what? I square RT. This is known as what? Joule's law of what heating. Joule's law of what heating. Okay. Now is there any applications of Joule's law? Now, is there any applications of Joule's law of heating? Yes, of course. Joule's law of heating is has been used or had been used in the what? In we can see in the what? In electric irons. Okay, roasters, etc. Okay, heaters also. So let us consider a bulb. Okay, let us consider this is an electric bulb. Okay, electric bulb. Okay, there is the what filament. Okay, filament. Now. The filament is made up of what? This filament is made up of tungsten. This filament is made up of what? Tungsten. Okay. Now there is what? There is what? We will get what nitrogen gas as well as argon on it. To what is the? When this here, when current passes through it, it becomes heated. Okay. Heat. When it gets heated, certain amount of what? Heat energy equal what certain amount of light energy what certain amount of electrical energy get converts into what light energy and some it forms in the heat energy. Okay, now what is the function of the nitrogen and argon? That it prolongs the what the life of the what the life of this what filament. Okay, it prolongs. Okay, it prolongs the life of the what filament. Now, what is the another use of this in the home? We know that we have in our in each and every one house we are having our fuse. Okay, we are having fuse. Now, what is the function of a fuse? Okay, the function of a fuse. Let us consider this is a house. Okay.
okay, in the house, in this house what we are getting, meter box, and then in the side of a meter box we are getting what, fuse system. Okay, now fuse, what is the function of a fuse? Okay, now this is nothing but a what, let us consider this is a wire. Okay, now this house requires, can have maximum amount of what, 10 ampere of what current. Okay, now 10 ampere of what current. Now if excess amount 15 ampere of current, okay, is goes to this circuit, goes towards this house, if 15 amount of, if this is not present, okay, if it goes directly, there is no connection. Okay, now if 15 ampere of current goes to this house, it requires 10 ampere. If 15 ampere of current passes to this house, as a result what will happen, this house will burn, short circuit in this what, house. Okay, short circuit. Now so what is the function of this fuse if I connect it? Okay, now this is connected, when this amount, they have 15 ampere of current passes, as a result there will be what, a connecting wire. Okay, when excess amount of current passes through it, then it, what will happen, if this wire gets melt, this wire get what, melts, as a result when it melts, then there will be no connection between this terminal and what, this terminal. So 15 ampere of current does not passes to what, this house. Okay, as a result there will be what, no short circuit. Okay, this is the function of a what, fuse. Okay, in each and every one house we are having what, fuse, and nowadays we are using MCB also. Now power means what, P, the rate of consumption of what, electrical, and the rate of consumption of electrical energy is called what, power. The power is nothing but P equal to what, power, when have power equal to what, work by time. Now work done is nothing but equal to heat by what, time. What you are getting, heat energy, H equal to what, I square R into T divided by T, T get cancelled, then what is the power, P equal to I square I into R. Okay, the power, electrical power is nothing but equal to I square into what, R. Okay, now what is the unit of power, unit of power is what, watt. Unit of power is what, watt. Now we use what, kilowatt. What, kW means what, we use kilowatt as unit. Okay, generally we use what, 1 kilowatt, 2 kilowatt, kilowatt is nothing but a unit. Okay, now 1 kilowatt hour we say as 1 watt unit, which is used. Okay, 1 kilowatt is equal to how much unit, 1 unit. In the meter reading what we are getting, 1 unit 2 unit 3 unit, means what it indicates, 1 kilowatt hour is nothing but equal to what, 1 unit. Now what is the value of 1 kilowatt hour? Okay, what is the value of 1 kilowatt hour if I convert it into joule? 1 kilowatt hour is nothing but 1 kilo means 1000 into 1000 watt, and into 1 hour equal to what, 60 minute into what, 60 second. Now if I calculate this value, 3 into 6 into 10 to the power what, 6, 3 into 6, 3.6 into 10 to the power 6 joule per what, second. Okay, 1 kilowatt hour is nothing but what, 3.6 into 10 to the power 6 joule watt per second. Okay, now in this chapter we have studied about what, first of all we have studied about current, then we have discussed about what potential, okay, then about Ohm's law, then we have studied about the factors on which the resistance depends, then we have studied about resistances in series, resistances in what, parallel, then the heating effects of what, the heating effect of what, current, and then we have studied about what, what this is power, that is called electrical what, power, power equal to work done by time. So work done is nothing but what, heat, h e by what, t. So work done is nothing but equivalent to what, heat, to h by t, h equal to what, from Joule's law, h equal to what, I square r t, then t cancel, the power equal to I square what, r, okay. Then with the unit of power is what, so 1 kilowatt equal to 1 kilowatt hour equal to what, 1 unit which is used. The 1 kilowatt hour equal to 1 kilo means 1000 into 1 hour equal to 60 minute into 60 second, so 3.6 into the after this minute. Thank you.